Dear students, in this lecture we will start with metal hydride reductions, and presently we will be discussing mainly lithium aluminum hydride in this lecture. As you know, the reduction can be defined as the conversion of an atom in a higher oxidation state to a lower oxidation state. For example, say if your reactant is having oxidation state 3, it may be converted into oxidation state 2, or if it is having 4, it may be converted into 2, or if oxidation state is 2, it can be converted into 1. So whenever any atom changes from higher oxidation state to a lower oxidation state in a given reaction, that reaction is defined as reduction. And second definition of reduction can be that if to a molecule we add hydrogen, so addition of hydrogen to a molecule is also called as reduction. For example, if we are having this type of a molecule, say carbonyl compound, and this is an unsaturated carbon oxygen bond, if we add hydrogen across this carbon oxygen bond, one hydrogen over here, one hydrogen over here, this will be converted into alcohols. So addition of hydrogen to any molecule is also known as reduction. That means carbonyl group is reduced to hydroxyl group. Similarly, if you see this molecule, this is a nitrile carbon nitrogen triple bonded molecule, and if we add hydrogen across these unsaturated bonds and these nitriles, they can be converted into amines. So such type of conversion of these types of molecules into other products by addition of hydrogen is called as reduction. And if you see this here, the oxidation state say is plus 1, and when hydrogen is added to this oxygen, then this becomes minus 1. So here gain of 2 electrons takes place when carbonyl groups, they are converted into alcohols. So basically gain of electrons is also a kind of reaction which we call as reduction. Here 2 electrons are being gained in this reaction, here 4 electrons are being gained in this reaction. So gain of electrons is also known as reduction. And as you know, a metal behaves as a reducing agent, which is a reverse reaction. So when lithium gives us lithium positive plus electron, we say that lithium has been oxidized to lithium metal. Lithium metal has been oxidized to lithium ions with the formation of electrons. And if reverse of this is happening, that lithium plus ions, they take up electrons to get converted into metal, then we say that whether that process is feasible or not, depending upon that, a metal will act as a reducing agent. So for example, high reduction potential of this reaction, that is lithium plus ion, when react with one electron to change into lithium metal, the reduction potential is minus 4.045 volts, which indicates that because this is having negative charge, so that means opposite of this is favored, and that means lithium metal is an excellent reducing agent, whereas lithium ion is poor oxidizing agent. And similarly, SN4 plus can be converted into SN2 plus, and it has a reduction potential of 0.15 volts, whereas if we react SN2 plus to Sn0, the reduction potential is negative, which indicates that this cation is a reducing agent. So based on the reduction potential, different metals, they will act as reducing agent. And such type of reductions where metal hydrides, they are involved in reduction of different types of molecules, they are the most commonly used complexes for conversion of different types of organic compounds into their reduced products. And most commonly used hydride complexes, they are lithium aluminium hydride, then alkoxy aluminate reagents, that is most of these they are derivatives of lithium aluminium hydride or some other aluminium derivatives. Then third category is borohydride based complexes, and most common among this is sodium borohydride, and then derivatives of other metal borohydrides, they have also been used in recent years for reduction of organic compound. And in this lecture we will discuss mainly about lithium aluminium hydride. Now lithium aluminium hydride is a strong reducing agent which can reduce aldehydes, esters, carboxylic acids, ketones, nitriles, epoxides and azides. And if you see all these, they are mostly unsaturated compounds, and these unsaturated compounds, they add hydrogen across their unsaturated bonds and get reduced with the help of lithium aluminium hydride. This lithium aluminium hydride is prepared by a reaction of lithium hydride with anhydrous aluminium chloride to give us lithium aluminium hydride, and lithium chloride is formed. And in the laboratory we can prepare like this, but on industrial scale the lithium aluminium hydride is prepared from sodium aluminium hydride. So when sodium metal reacts with aluminium metal and hydrogenation is done, then we will get sodium aluminium hydride, which on reaction with lithium chloride will give us lithium aluminium hydride on an industrial scale. And one thing which needs to be noted is that lithium aluminium hydride needs to be used only in the anhydrous conditions, because it reacts with the moisture and it reacts violently with water to give us lithium hydroxide, aluminium hydroxide and hydrogen gas is evolved. So that is why all reactions of lithium aluminium hydride, they are performed in polar aprotic solvents. So these are the different functional groups, and these are the products formed from these functional groups. For example, aldehydes and ketones, they are converted into primary and secondary alcohols respectively. Carboxylic acids, they are converted into primary alcohols. Acetic anhydrides, they are converted into primary alcohols. Acid chlorides, they are converted into primary alcohols. Esters, we will get two types of alcohols as product. One is this one, this will be reduced to a primary alcohol, and this part will be either primary, secondary or tertiary alcohol depending upon the nature of this alkyl group which is present in the ester. Similarly, these types of secondary amides, they will be converted into secondary amines. And these types of tertiary amides, N,N-dialkylamides, these are N-alkylamides, these are N,N-dialkylamides. So they will give us tertiary amines as the product, or secondary amino alcohols, they are formed as the product. Similarly, nitriles, they will give us amines as the product. Oxymes, they will also give us amines as the product. aryl nitro compounds, they will give us azo compounds as the final product, whereas alkyl nitro compounds, they will give us, this should be RNH2. So alkylamines, they will be formed as product. So basically what happens is that lithium aluminium hydride coordinates with the reactant, say in case of all these derivatives of carbonyl compounds. So carbonyl compound will be coordinated at the carbonyl oxygen with the lithium aluminium hydride, and hydride will be transferred to the electrophilic carbon which is present in the carbonyl compound. So this is the basic mechanism that how lithium aluminium hydride works. So basically, as I told you, that lithium aluminium hydride, lithium is a positive part, this will be having a coordination with the electronegative oxygen, whereas hydride ion will attack the electrophilic carbon, and we will get a complex of this type, where this oxygen active will form a bond with the aluminium to give us alkoxy aluminate intermediate of this type. And this alkoxy aluminate intermediate will react with another carbonyl compound, another molecule of the carbonyl compound, and one more hydride ion will be shifted to the carbonyl compound like this, and we will get dialkoxy aluminate intermediates. Then this will react with another molecule, then one more hydride will be replaced by alkoxy group. Then the fourth molecule of carbonyl compound will react, and we will get these types of trialkoxy aluminium intermediates as the product, and these on hydrolysis will give us four molecules of the respective alcohols from the carbonyl compound. So this is how a carbonyl compound will be converted into an alcohol. And if this is a ketone, we will get secondary alcohols, and if this is an aldehyde, that means one of the alkyl group will be hydrogen over here, then we will get primary alcohols as the product. And it has been seen that when one of the alkyl group is hydrogen, that is in case of aldehydes, the rate of reduction is faster because of the less steric hindrance present in case of aldehyde in comparison to ketones. So rate of reduction of aldehydes is faster than the ketones. So these are some of the examples where we can see that which functional group is being converted into which functional group. For example, if we are having these types of alpha amino acids, when these are reacted with lithium aluminium hydride, the carboxylic acid functional group is converted into primary alcohol as the product. Then for example, in this case, if we are using lithium aluminium hydride, this is the aldehydic functional group. When this is reacted at 0 degree centigrade, then aldehyde is converted into the primary alcohol as the product. And you can see that this reaction is a selective reaction, where this carbon-carbon double bond or this carbonyl group where oxygen and nitrogen is attached to the carbonyl group, they are not affected by lithium aluminium hydride. Only aldehydic functional group is reduced to the primary alcohol. Similarly, in this case, this is an example of a lactam cyclic amide. So here only a keto group is reduced to the methylene group. So lactams, they are not reduced to alcohols, but they are reduced to hydrocarbons in presence of lithium aluminium hydride. So some very important applications in synthesis for lithium aluminium hydride. For example, in this aldehydic moiety, we are having this ether linkage also, and this ether linkage also, and a halogen atom also present on the aromatic ring. But lithium aluminium hydride selectively reduces only aldehydic group to the primary alcohol, and this reaction has been used in the synthesis of Shuvin for thin B, which is a biologically active compound, and this product is formed in 92% yield. Similarly, in case of alpha beta unsaturated carbonyl compounds, then when we are using lithium aluminium hydride in THF, then we will get both the type of product. One product is where only carbonyl group will be reduced to give us this type of product, where carbon-carbon double bond is not affected, whereas other product is formed where reduction at carbonyl group as well as carbon-carbon double bond also takes place. So in such cases, we say that 1-2 addition or 1-4 addition takes place in case of these types of alpha beta unsaturated compounds. So for example, in case of benzyl acetone, this is benzyl acetone, we will get either this type of allylic alcohols, which is formed by normal 1-2 addition to the carbonyl group, whereas the product E is formed by 1-4 reduction. So what happens is two molecules of this benzyl acetone, they form alkoxy intermediate with the lithium aluminium hydride. So first, that means 1-2 reduction of this benzyl acetone takes place to give us base alkoxy aluminate intermediate of this type. Then this intermediate gets converted into this type of cyclic intermediate, which on hydrolysis gives us a saturated product by 1-4 reduction. So we can say that reduction of alpha beta unsaturated carbonyl compounds is not a selective reduction by lithium aluminium hydride, because both the products, they are formed during the reaction. Now we can see over here that if the reduction proceed by coordination of aluminium, say if path A is followed, then 1-2 reduction will take place, and we will get this type of intermediate, which on hydrolysis will give us the allylic alcohol as the product. Whereas if path B is followed, the first attack will be at the 4 position, and one overall reduction will be 1-4 reduction to give us the final product. Now if the R group in A is small, this R group is small, then this product formation will predominate, because then there will be less steric hindrance, and only product formed will be by 1-2 reduction, or 1-2 addition will predominate. And if this R1 and R2 groups, they increase in size, that means attack of hydride to this carbon will be a difficult one. So if this is small and these are large, then 1-2 additions, they will predominate. But if these groups, they are small, say these are hydrogens, then attack by hydride will be facilitated at this carbon, then 1-4 additions, they will be preferred. Now some examples of different types of functional groups. For example, reduction of carboxylic acids. As I have told you, that carboxylic acids, they are reduced to primary alcohols. So this was also observed in this example, where which was studied by Passero and Webster in the synthesis of female sex pheromones of citrus mellibug, that is Planococcus citri. This carboxylic acid, which is present in this female sex pheromone, is reduced to this alcohol on use of lithium aluminium hydride. And if we use carboxylic acids which are having tero atom at the alpha position, then also we will get the corresponding alcohols. Similarly, carboxylic esters, they can also give us different types of products. And as I have told you, two products will be formed. One will be the primary alcohol, and other will be another alcohol which may be primary, secondary or tertiary, depending upon what is the alkyl group present in the starting material at this position. And the beauty of this reaction is that products, they are formed without loss of stereochemistry at the alpha carbon of the ester. For example, if we study the reduction of this tertiary butyl ester group in this compound, so you can see over here, when this is reduced, the one product formed will be this tertiary alcohol. Tertiary butyl alcohol will be formed, and this will be reduced to the primary alcohol. So this part will be formed as primary alcohol. In addition, we will get tertiary butyl alcohol. And you can see, when this is reacted with aqueous alcohol, this product is being converted into keto group only when this is reacted with aqueous HCl, because otherwise this is acting as a protecting group for these ketones. We can selectively reduce this ester group, and this keto group can be protected by making a triethylsilyl salt of this carbonyl compound. And you can see that stereochemistry at this position is maintained in the product also. So stereochemistry at the alpha carbon of the ester is not disturbed by lithium aluminium hydride reduction. Similarly, when these types of esters, they are reacted with lithium aluminium hydride, then we will get allylic alcohols as the product by selective 1,2 reduction of these conjugate esters. So, because of the conjugation present, we will get allylic alcohols as the product. Then similarly, lactones are cyclic esters, they can form diols as the product. And most common example is this enterodiol synthesis, where this lactone is reduced to this diol using lithium aluminium hydride. So basically what happens is, as you have seen in case of esters, we are getting two alcohols. One is cleavage at this point, we will get this alcohol, and then this carbonyl group will be reduced to primary alcohol. So this will get CH2OH over here, this CH2OH by cleavage of this bond. So we will get diols as the product. Similarly, when lactone is sterically hindered, so for example, in this case, this lactone is, this carbonyl group is sterically hindered because of the presence of this methyl group over here and this methyl group over here. And because of that, cleavage of this bond is not possible, and only reduction of this carbonyl group will take place, and we will get the partial reduction to give us lactol as the product. So lactones, they are partially reduced to give us lactols as the product, where the lactones, they are having sterically hindered carbonyl compound. Similarly, amides, they can be reduced to amines through intermediate ammonium salts. The mechanism of this reaction is like this. As you have seen in case of carbonyl compounds, hydride will shift to more electrophilic carbon, lithium will shift to oxygen, and then this type of intermediate will be formed. And because of the presence of lone pair of lactones on nitrogen, this will move to this to create a carbon nitrogen double bond, and this alkoxy aluminium hydride will be eliminated, and we will get these types of intermediate ammonium salts as the intermediate products. So these intermediate ammonium salts, then again they will react with another molecule of lithium aluminium hydride, and then reduction of this carbon nitrogen double bond will take place, and we will get amines as the product. So this is how amides, they are converted into amines through these two types of intermediates. First alkoxy aluminium intermediates, and then these types of carbon nitrogen double bonded aluminium salt intermediates. So example is this one. In the synthesis of cuminacin B, this amide group is reduced to CH2 by this lithium aluminium hydride. So amides, they are converted into tertiamines in this case. Similarly, cyclic amides, they are called as lectums, and the lectums, they can be converted into cyclic amines as the product. So final product will be the amines in this case also. So for example, in case of 2-pyrrolidinone derivatives, this is the intermediate which is formed. Alpha amino alcohol is formed as the intermediate product, and this undergo elimination of water, and we will get these types of ammonium salts as intermediates, and these ammonium salts on further reduction with lithium aluminium hydride, they are converted into cyclic amines. So this is an example of reduction of lactams in case of this lactam. The stereochemistry of the lactam is maintained in the formation of crispin A. This is the cyclic amine which is formed from this lactam. So cyclic amide is converted into cyclic amine. So this amide is converted into this tertiary amine as the product, and name of this tertiary amine is crispin A. Similarly, epoxides, they can also be reduced to the corresponding alcohols they are formed. And here the reaction is generally stereoselective, that lithium aluminium hydride adds hydride selectively to the less substituted carbon of the epoxide. So for example, if we see this epoxide, this carbon is having two hydrogens, this carbon is having two alkyl groups. So that means this is less substituted carbon. So that means hydrogen will be hydride will be added to the less substituted carbon of the epoxide. So this CH2 will be converted into CH3, and this will form alcohol. So this is how alpha bisabolol will be formed by the reduction of this type of epoxide. So the hydride can be given to more substituted carbon also, and that will take place when epoxide oxygen can coordinate with aluminium via an 8 complex. So opposite to this can also happen, but under selective conditions. Similarly, reduction of nitriles can lead to the formation of amines, and the mechanism is similar to what we have seen in case of carbonyl compounds or amides. So here the nitrile will react with lithium aluminium hydride to give us this type of amino aluminate complex, and this amino aluminate complex will react with another molecule of the nitrile to give us bis amino aluminate intermediates, and this bis amino aluminate intermediates, they on reduction with another molecule of lithium aluminium hydride will be converted into these types of saturated trialumino alkyl intermediates, and these on hydrolysis will give us amines as the product. So for example, in this case, this cyano group will be converted into primary amino group in case of tubifilone synthesis, and you can see that stereochemistry of the reactant is maintained in the product also, because here the reaction is taking place only at this nitrile, and that is why the stereochemistry of the reactant is maintained throughout the reaction. Similarly, azides, these types of compounds, they are called as azides. Azides on reduction with lithium aluminium hydride gives us amines as the product, and here also the selectivity of the reactant is maintained throughout the reaction, and we will get product with 96% enantiomeric excess, and the product is formed overall, yield of the product formed is 99% in this case. Then nitro groups, as I've told you that aryl nitro compounds, they are converted into azo compounds, carbon-carbon, nitrogen-nitrogen double bond is there. Two molecules of this nitrobenzene, they will combine to give us azobenzene as the product when we reflux this with lithium aluminium hydride. Similarly, if we are having alpha beta unsaturated nitro compounds, then they are reduced to primary amines as the product. And if we are having alkyl nitro compounds, then also we will get primary amines as the product. So here you can see in case of alpha beta unsaturated compounds, the nitrogen oxygen bond is also reduced, and carbon carbon bond is also reduced in this case. Similarly, alkyl halides, they undergo hydrogenolysis reaction, then X is replaced by hydride ion. So minus X is, X goes as minus X, and hydride ion is added to the reactant. So that means one bromobutane will be converted into N-butane in presence of lithium aluminium hydride. So for example, in the synthesis of clavosolide A, this type of bromo derivative on reaction with lithium aluminium hydride, so Br negative will be removed, and hydride ion will add to this, CH2 will become CH3. So this is hydrogenolysis of this bond will take place to give us reduction hydrocarbon as the products. and here also stereochemistry of the reactant is maintained because the reaction is taking place only at this carbon and no other carbon or oxygen is involved in the reaction. Then sulfonate esters, they can also be reduced to alcohols through reaction with lithium aluminum hydride. For example, if we are having this type of alcohols, here this hydroxyl group is a secondary hydroxyl group, this hydroxyl group is a primary hydroxyl group, and when this is reacted with paratoluene sulfonyl chloride, then tosylate of this primary alcohol will be formed, and this tosylate on reduction with lithium aluminum hydride, sulfonate ester of this will be undergo hydrogenolysis, and this CH2 will become CH3. So this is how sulfonate esters, they can also be reduced using lithium aluminum hydride, and hydrogenolysis of the carbon oxygen bond will take place to give us these types of product. Then similarly, lithium aluminum hydride can react with these types of propargyl alcohol derivatives also, and this reaction is known as Whiting reaction. And these alkenyl diols, they can give us dienes as the product through reduction with lithium aluminum hydride. So this is a special type of lithium aluminum hydride reduction. Otherwise, lithium aluminum hydride does not reduce alkenes and alkenyl moieties. So carbon-carbon double bond or carbon-carbon triple bond otherwise is not affected by lithium aluminum hydride, but when we are having propargyl alcohols, then these are reduced to dienes as the product, and you can see that carbon-carbon double bonds they are formed. So this lecture has been prepared mainly from fourth edition of Caruthers, and in addition examples have been taken from some journals and other internet material also. Thank you very much for your patience hearing. Thank you.